your title itself, GROOM, it is an acronym. So what does that acronym stand for our viewing audience?
Well, in Los Angeles, I was designing the name, my first and middle name, which was Octavius Marshawn, where I did celebrity placements like Queen Latifah, Mary J. Blige, Ariana Grande, Chris Brown, and Nick Cannon, to name a few. And we were just after, and this was before the Grammys, so we were just talking about after we did the Grammy suits, and then I did some more suits, and every time we would do something on social media with suits, everybody's like, oh my gosh, where'd you get that suit? Can you help us with our tuxedos? Can you help us pick them out? And we're not listening to all the whispers, and so we got up one morning, after he actually did a celebrity stint on RuPaul's Drag Race in one of my suits, where even RuPaul was like, I have to have that suit.
Oh, wow.
And he came up to me, he said, do you have a suit company? And I said, yeah, we do. So we went
home. No, we don't.
So that was kind of the engine. And we got up the next morning and said, that's it. I said, we just need to be the Vera Wang of men's suiting.
You just recently made a big splash here in New York City with your collection having a presentation style here at in New York. So how did that go? Can you explain? How did it turn out for you?
Yeah, it went really, really well because we had our first big show when we launched our company November 15th of last year. So it's only been about 3 or 4 months.
Oh.
And we felt it was time to come back to New York. We hadn't been here about 3 years. We got a lot of press from our presentation in LA, including New York's Uptown Magazine, for their wedding issue as well. So we thought it was time to come out. And we got that allowed that chance to do it here. And to kind of meet a lot of people that we haven't met through our social media, so that was a good time.
Yeah, a friend of ours, Frank Watson, he hosts parties here in New York, and when he found out about The Line, and there's also a company called Dateable. They were doing a Valentine's type event, and when they found out about our company, because we were focused on the wedding market with our tuxedos.
The men's side of it.
They thought it would be a perfect fit. And, you know, especially the way our company came about was, you know, we got married in 2014 on the Grammys. And we didn't have anybody to, we wanted tuxedos, but we wanted to do something non-traditional because we weren't getting married in the most traditional way, you know, it was on television.
Queen Latifah's officiating that wedding.
Wow. You know, so we were like, you know, well, you know, he asked me, well, what are we gonna do? And I was like, you're gonna design our tuxes. You know, this is what you went to school for, and fashion is something that's always been a part of our lives. And so, you know, he designed our tuxes and. We really, you know, from that, people were asking, where did we get it, and all this kind of stuff, and so that's kind of
snowball.
It sounds like
a snowball. It started with one situation, a perfect setup, and then it just snowballed out of that, which works. I mean, you think about you, both of your platforms you had been designing for way before the Grammys, and it just so happened you designed the tux for the Grammys,
And he's always been a part of things like that, choreography director, actually being there and him being people wondering like, what are you doing here? You working? Like, no, I'm getting married. So it was a big deal. And like you said, organically the company came about just because even when we were doing it, there was such a void when we were looking around for things like tuxedos and even cake toppers for the wedding side.
I can imagine.
And even men of color.
Very biased.
Even cake toppers of people of color, not just men, but people of color. And not only, I mean, we're black owned business now that we keep forgetting about that as well. But we've had some success, and a lot of people have known us because of the guys that did the white suits. You know? But our suits are not always white. But again, we thought that we needed to do something to make a splash, to be, you know, comparable to like a Vera Wang, but for men, and especially with everybody out there that's been in existence forever, like the Tom Fords. We need to do something that shed a light on us, that would separate us.